get ready to match the stars from Real People, Skip Stevenson, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reddy, from Days of Our Lives, Melinda O'Fee, McLean Stevenson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Reimer.
Yes.
Leave her alone, will you?
Gotta watch him.
Right. Hello there.
I think everyone should have a hobby.
All right. Any... Hello there.
I
thought you were going to walk out.
No, I decided to stay when I saw her come out, and then I said, I better stay for a while.
Yeah.
She's certainly coming out.
The gold. The gold is beautiful, isn't it? How does
there
this
is.
Photograph... Oh, isn't that pretty? Yes.
Didn't know gold was that flexible, did you?
No.
I feel like a big Rugerad.
Right.
Or two big ones, whichever comes first. I'm just kidding.
All right. He's just kidding, folks. Say. Let's say hello to Morris Smith and Susie Haynes. They've been around here for a while. Morris Smith of the LAPD. And Susie Haynes, who is training a 4-year-old Arabian steed.
Uh-huh.
That's really quite an accomplishment. All right. They've played one game. She won the game. She has $500. We are about to conclude the second game.
Right.
And she has four celebrity matches, and you have none. So you have one shot at it, Morris, and this is it. You want A or B?
I'll take B.
Okay. Right. You need four to tie and five to win.
Shake Ralph, you up a little, doesn't it?
Yes. Ralph said, this town is really tough.
Yeah.
How tough is it?
How tough is it?
You're the only one that was on time.
Right. Here's how tough it is. At the local strip joint, all the girls have to wear bulletproof blanks. They're all ready. Morris, I know this is a subject that must be strange to you. Here it is. Ralph said this town is really tough. At the local strip joint, all the girls have to wear bulletproof blanks.
Bras.
Bras.
Wrong
do they wear?
Again.
They don't wear bras in strip joints, do they?
Well, they do when they start off.
Oh, when they start off, they do wear bras. Right. All right. But when they get down to it, they wear other things.
Yeah, you've heard of,
what's that?
You've heard of training bras, haven't you?
Training bras.
I've always wanted to get a job training them. It'd be.
Yeah.
From what I hear, you did.
Yeah. Anyway, you want to know my answer, don't you?
I do want to. All girls have to wear bulletproof what?
Being somebody who actually emceed strip shows a long time ago, be bulletproof pasties. Is that the same as a bra?
No, pasties are a little smaller than bras.
Well, maybe the other things are smaller, too. You never know.
You really did? That's what you
Yeah, I was there. I used to catch the clothes.
Really?
Anything else?
And I'd catch them, and it was just an awful job. I'll tell you about it later. You had to kind of see it.
Well, I'd like to hear about it, huh?
No, not now, Frank.
Well, I didn't say no. I said later. Didn't I say later? Well, this isn't even a match. I don't even know what this means.
Well, it's a foregone conclusion.
I know
it's
what
not
it
a match.
G-string!
Yes.
G-string. Well, now you gotta match everybody else here. Morris,
pretty much
stay in the game. Charles?
Pasties.
All right, so that means Susie wins. What'd the bottom tier have? Pasties! Pasties would have won it for you. Come on down here. You probably even don't know what pasties are, do you? Pasties are the little things they paste on in certain places.
Yeah, well, I don't...
You don't frequent those places.
Yeah.
Morris, it was a pleasure to meet a kind gentleman like you from the LAPD. We're going to send some gifts your way. We're going to send a case of gout and all kinds of wonderful prizes.
Okay.
Nice to meet you, sir. Thank you for being here on Match Game. Morris Smith. There we go. I don't know how tight you can get with your camera, but this lady really did an interesting job in matching everything. She's got, now wait a minute now, this red matches this red, which matches this red, which matches this red, which
Find
matches
one more match, you're going to jail.
This red here, which in turn matches that red there. Can you see that red?
And Jane, right. She turned her dress around.
Her dress is
the other
way.
Oh, she turned her dress around. She
don't
did.
Me. Didn't right. notice,
we were
did
kidding
you?
About it yesterday.
It was great. I was there when it happened.
I had to wear it again.
Right. Look at that. She wore it this way yesterday. And now she's...
Now she wants money so she can get another dress and she'll have four.
Right. Thank you for doing that for our benefit. Susie, well, this is your second shot at it. Let's see how you do this time. We polled a studio audience since we said write down your best answer to this. Faster than a blink.
Oh!
Betty.
Faster than a speeding bullet.
All right.
Skip.
That's the one I was going to say. Faster than a rabbit?
Faster than a rabbit?
Don't turn on me yet. Well, yeah, turn on me. I think, yeah.
Charles.
He's thinking.
Than a train.
Faster than a train?
Oh, you like that better, huh? I see.
Faster than a train.
All right, so you have rabbit, train, and speeding bullet.
I'm going to go with Betty and speeding bullet.
All right, let's see if we have a speeding bullet up there. And if so, well, may we see the $100 response, if you please. Faster than a plane. All right.
More powerful than a locomotive, right?
Charles said train. He's a little
train.
Behind the time.
All right. Faster than a what for the 250? Hey, rabbit, there you are. You see?
Yeah, go ahead. How you like?
You were putting him down. He was right all along. Right. Last chance. Here we go. Speeding bullet. There we go. Okay, Jen. I saw you.
I can't see me.
All right. Now you've got another $500, means the least to play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000, but a shot at $10,000. Now, with a spin of the wheel, good luck to you. Here we go. $10,000 is at stake here. No help from the audience, if you please, because your answer may be the incorrect one. Although we appreciate your interest and cooperation, and thanks for showing up and all that. Then. You ready, Miss Brett? Good luck to you. You've got to match Brett now.
Yeah, blank. Right, so she'll come up here, we.
Measure. M-E-A-S-U-R-E. Blank measure. Blank measure. All right, Brett's made up her mind. Your job is to match her. If you do that, you get $10,000.
Full measure. No?
Full measure. Well, that didn't even occur to me, full measure.
Well, this audience would be fun at a funeral, wouldn't they?
Yeah.
Listen, I feel really terrible because I thought there were two answers. And
what?
One was measure for measure. The other was tape measure.
Tape measure is a good one. Sorry about that.
You still have your two dresses. Don't worry.
You got two dresses, and you got $1,000. $1,000. That's not bad. All right, while we say goodbye to Susie, let's do a little message for America. Let's welcome two more players, and here they come, Sandy Ricks and Beth Creighton.
Hold everything.
One of you has a large family. That's you?
Got him.
Who's there?
Well, I have my son, Mark Ricks, known as Tough Ricks.
Where
Tough
is he?
Red. Mark, under your jacket.
Oh, in the jacket. On the end?
On the end there. And then I have a friend, Miles.
Yeah.
And little niece, Erin.
Right.
And my daughter, Jennifer. That's little Red.
Right.
And in the back is little Amy.
Where's Amy? Over there?
And then I have a friend, John.
Where's John? Hello, John.
My sister, Rochelle.
Rochelle.
My friend, Rosie.
Where, Rosie?
My friend, Mary Kay.
Holy mackerel.
And my dear friend, Diane.
And Diane, too?
Diane.
Listen, without you, we would have had an empty house.
The other two people out there are friends of mine.
Oh, they are. Where are you from, Sandy?
I now live in Thousand Oaks with my two children, and I work for an oil exploration firm in Westlake.
All right. Good luck to you, Sandy. Beth, tell us about you, please.
I'm originally from Jersey City, New Jersey.
Hey.
I lived in Las Vegas for a few years and attended the university there. And currently I'm living in Los Angeles and working in the apparel industry and sales.
All right. Good luck to you, too, Beth. Here we go, ladies. Sandy, A or B?
I'm going to go with B.
B.
Please.
You got anybody out here, Beth? How many?
Six.
Six? I tell you, between the two of them, we're pretty lucky. Oh, the people who couldn't get in, I'm sorry about that. Here it is. Ben said, that pirate must have been a doctor. Instead of a hook, he's got a blank. All right, Sandy. Ben said that pirate must have been a doctor. Instead of a hook, he's got a blank.
A scalpel.
Good. Not a bad one at all.
That's not a bad one. I think that's probably the best one.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah, now that I think about it.
Oh, you didn't?
Kind of wished I'd have thought about it about 30 seconds ago. I would have felt better, but I couldn't fit this all in one word, but I thought maybe a stethoscope.
Stethoscope? All right. What do you say?
Gee whiskers, criminy Dutch.
You spelled it different, though.
How did you spell yours?
With an A.
Oh, well, you're probably right. Stethoscope.
They're going to boo
I'm
you, too. It
doesn't. Sorry.
Yeah.
All right. See, to me, stethoscope doesn't make sense because if the hook coming out of his arm, you see,
well,
the stethoscopes have a little limp hunk of. You have a question?
When in our recent memory have Brett and Skip made any sense?
Oh, never. Never. That's right. Very important. Good point.
When in my recent memory has the show made any sense?
The floor now belongs to Charles Nelson Reilly.
Scalpel.
Uh-huh.
Hey.
Well,
hey, excuse me.
That pirate must have been a doctor. Instead of a hook, he's got a scalpel, according to her. What?
Oh, I think scalpel's a much better answer than a stethoscope, but Skip looked over my shoulder again. I tried to throw him off guard.
You did, too. Twice.
All right, McLean.
I also was looking over her shoulder and came up with stethoscope.
See, I'm not the only one.
Yes.
Is that spoken?
There we go. This
well, there's an O there.
Oh.
Isn't that right?
I don't know.
Right after Melinda.
$5 yes, she's got.
Right, Melinda O'Fee. Right.
I seem to be the only one on the lower tier who can keep her mind on her work.
So.
Scalpel.
Yeah. Uh-huh. So, Sandy, you got two. Beth, let's see how you do with this. Henry said, my wife is the world's worst cook. I need an electric knife just to cut the blank. Henry said, my wife is the world's worst cook. I need an electric knife just to cut the blank.
Potatoes.
Potatoes. Good. An electric knife just to cut the potatoes.
Well, no, first I thought cut the mustard would be a thing.
Cut the mustard.
It would appear to me that if she was that bad of a cook, you'd have to have an electric knife just to cut the butter.
All right. Tough butter. Mm-hmm. Never saw that. Yes?
If you can't cut the mustard, don't pick up the knife.
All right. That's the saying. A little homily here. Pay attention. Write those things down there. You can use
coming
them
out in hard copy
later.
In spring.
Yes, sir.
Although I'm not speaking to several people, I still, through my anger and disappointment, manage to match.
Aha!
Well done, Charles.
All right, Melinda O. My wife is the world's worst cook. I need an electric knife just to cut the.
Well, you should have.
Looked over your shoulder,
this time, darling. Potatoes.
Potatoes.
Oh. I'll be doggone.
I thought potatoes was a rotten answer, and look how it's working for her.
I have. I reinstated your faith in rotten answers. I put cut the cheese.
Cut the cheese. That's related
to. I wanted to do that and just went ahead and did it.
Is that related?
You just did it now?
Related to cut the mustard?
Yes.
I see.
Just
all
did
right,
it now.
Betty.
Did you? Well.
I think Skip peaked about 4 years ago, and it's been downhill since then.
Yes.
The smashed potatoes.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So, 3-2. Good tight game going here. 3-2. We'll continue with round two in a moment. Now this for you.
Here again, the star of our show, Gene Reven.
Okay, Gene. Here we go, ladies. Now, Beth, your head's in. The rule says the person whose head must go first. That's you.
I'd like B, please.
All right. Skip, Brett, and McLean.
Okay.
Dumb Donald was so dumb.
Oh,
He went to the new stadium and tried to blank the artificial grass. Ready, Brett?
Well, this is Jimmy Stewart. Here we go.
Dumb Donald was so dumb, he went to the new stadium and tried to blank the artificial grass.
Mo.
She said Mo, one of three good choices.
My
here.
First thought was, if he was in that condition, maybe smoke.
That's one of the three good choices.
Then you'd have to get
choices.
Some plastic papers, and it wouldn't work. So I guess she is right. Mo, the artificial
Mo
grass.
Mo it is. Four for her.
I threw out Mo and went for fertilize.
Fertilize? Water, Mo, all those things are good. You don't play, do you? Oh. Something you want to talk about?
Boscany.
Oh, all right. Now, you don't play either. McLean plays.
Fine, thank you.
Yes. Good. Tried to blank the artificial grass.
You got it. Well, I think this is the same as Mo. Cut.
Cut. Indeed it is. So he got the 5. Now, Sandy, you know what you have to do?
I do.
You got to play catch up.
Okay.
3-4. Mean Martha is really mean.
How mean is she?
Not only does she hang her plants, she blanks them.
Well, I guess Mean Martha is really mean. Not only does she hang her plants.
That's right, you said.
I know, yeah.
I heard it someplace.
Here we go. Mean Martha's really mean. Not only does she hang her plants, she blanks them.
She shakes them? No.
Shakes? Well, she hung them, and she was mean, you know. Hang in the sense of, well, never mind. You'll find out in a moment.
I was shaking my plants out the window one night, and I got arrested.
Really?
Yeah. I have some azaleas.
What did you do?
I figure that she was so mean that she not only hung her plants, but she eats her plants.
Eats the plants. I gotta match everybody else here, Sandy.
Oh, no, she not only hangs her plants, she draws and quarters them.
All right, so that means Beth wins the game. What do you have down here? Thanks. Strangle. Come on down, Beth. We're gonna spin you off for just a little while. You'll be back for game number 2 later. In the meantime, we have this for you, America, wherever you are. There you are.
Would you ask her if she'll marry me? Because
I'm
afraid, yeah.
Melinda O'Fee.
Yes?
The gentleman in back of you is proposing marital union.
Charles!
No, this one here. Skip.
See how the women are nuts over me, Gene?
Yeah, they all love you, Charles. We all love you, too.
I call Robert Redford and my friend Burt Reynolds every day. I say, fellas, how can we get through another day of this?
You mean
not
Steve?
Not easy.
Skip.
Steve?
Skip.
Oh, Skip.
Skip.
Skip Stevenson.
It's okay.
Steve
I'm
Skippinson. Yeah.
What do you think?
What do you do exactly?
I do it real well, whatever it is.
First, dancing.
Have we arranged something?
Yes, I want to see what
Let's
he does
Let's just
well.
Try it out.
All right.
That'd be.
Yes.
Can you say a few words of Titus over the weekend?
Yes, all right. I'm serving as a matchmaker, and we now join this couple in holy Holy mackerel. Join us next time for the Match Game. Gene Rayburn, goodbye.
Today's contestants will also...
Steve, Clorox, the breath deodorant, helps your mouth stone fresh and power, eliminate bad breath. Costs a little more, but it's worth it. Clorox. From across the Pacific comes the Hawaiian Tropic natural tanning lotions and oils, plus this Hawaiian Tropic flow, the Hawaiian Tropic to tan of the island. Off and off. Towelettes mosquito repellent off. Really works with the most effective mosquito repellent ingredient money can buy. When you've got anything to stick to sweep, reach for WD-40. Makes things work smoother, last longer. Do it yourself with WD-40.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.